أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله مالك تعالى واستعين به واستغفره واستهديه وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. Let's see the verse still in the chapter of the heights, verse 56. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is giving us message here. Said ولا تفسدوا في الأرض بعد إصلاحه ولا تفسدوا في الأرض بعد إصلاحه وادعوه خوفا وطمعا إن رحمة الله قريب من المحسنين. See this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us order. It's not order, it's nahi, wala, because the Quran is if'al wala taf'al, do and don't. Hina bulak don't. Ayo, that's why. Yani, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, don't make mischief on the earth after it has been set in order. Who set it in order? Allah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, He organized it. Everything was in its spot. Perfect. But when the insan, by his choice, put his hand, a lot of corruption there. That's why Allah said, وَلَا تُفْسِدُوا. Don't make mischief on earth. Don't make mischief on earth. After it has been set in order, and invoke Allah Almighty with fear and hope. With fear and hope. وَدْعُوهُ خَوْفًا وطمع. Indeed, Allah's mercy is close to the doers of good. إن رحمة الله قريب من المحسنين. Let's see, يعني, very short ayah, but let's see, there is a message here. There is a message. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He created the earth, He created the earth before even He created the man, right? The earth, it was for jinn before us. The jinn, they said, dwell here on the earth. They make mischief and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wipe them out. And al-malaika, they kick them out to the oceans after killing too many of them. Jinn. After they make mischief. Tayyib. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam, and Adam, he became Khalifa. Inni ja'alum fil ardi Khalifa. For the earth, it is the place for the Khalifa of Allah. Who is the Khalifa of Allah? You and me. Al-insan, the human. We are the children of Adam. That's why al-ard is the makan. مكان for الخليفه, the one who gonna dwell here, gonna live here. فالله سبحانه وتعالى, when he created, he set it in order. سبحانه وتعالى, he fixed it like the bed of the baby. مهد الذي جعل لكم الارض مهدا. الله said in the Quran, he made the earth for us مهد. What is المهد? When you have an infant baby, you see his parents, they make very comfortable bed for him. Yeah, so that's why Allah fixed it for us. He set it in order for us. That's why He said, وَلَا تُفْسِدُوا يَا خَرْبَنِينَ. Don't make mischief into خَرْبَنِين. You are the one who is making خَرَاب, corruption on earth. This is, I mean, the word. خَرَاب means corruption. Somebody خَرْبَان, he is the one who is making corruption himself. Allah said, وَلَا تُفْسِدُوا. Don't make mischief on earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah created the earth, جَعَلَ فِيهَا مُقَوْمَاتِ الْحَيَاةِ. يعني مُقَوْمَاتِ الْحَيَاةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created the sky for you, heavy, and has the sun, the moon. Imagine if you live without the sun. It's going to be darkness all night. Imagine if there is no stars in the sky. How it's going to be dark all night. Imagine if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give us that oxygen to breathe. And the air, which is what has carrying the oxygen, is not moving. Yes, what's going to happen? يعني احنا, when we sit like number of people and we don't have air conditioning here, the all sun-exuded carbon, CO2, will go out from your body and there is no oxygen. We're going to say, I'm choking, I cannot breathe. Why? Because there is no fresh air, no oxygen. For Allah created this free for us. Water, free for you. He gave you the sun, the moon, the earth, everything. Do you have, and all being subjugated for us, do you have any choice that you can give order to the sun one day and say, sun, don't come? Do you have that choice? No. Do you have the choice to own the water? No. Do you have the choice to tell the moon, don't come? Or there is no oxygen anywhere? Do you know if that's going to be in our hand, we're going to kill each other. Now, one of the major signs of the day of judgment, people will fight for the water. See what happened to Egypt and the Abyssinia and the Israel, they are in the middle, and you know, look what happened to Erdogan when he make dams and in the Firat, and the Iraqi people now they have no water because Mr. Erdogan Effendi. Yes, in Syria too, the same thing. And Jordan too. See, yes, I was in Jordan. Right, right. Which I'll be sure to tell you more. مهم يعني خربانة كلها الله يعين الخربانة و people they kill each other as in they want dams and no خلاص not yours mine and Allah سبحانه وتعالى is giving us water plenty الله العظيم بس احنا just want to control each other فالله subjugated everything whatever his creatures in need they cannot live without it he put it in his hand he didn't give it to us he did not give it to us but he gave you choices for certain things. You cannot change the way of the wind or the sun, the moon or the stars. All of this in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because all of us need it. Otherwise we're going to kill each other. Subhanallah. فالفساد. طيب, where is the corruption comes from? Or that mischief comes from? Comes بسبب ملكات الاختيار الموجودة فيه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us some kind of a choice, right? And because of that little choice Allah gave it to us, we make corruption on earth. Wallahi al-azim. Do you know if we don't have a choice like the sun, the moon, the earth, the animals, the malaika, khalas, we're gonna listen, obey, that's it. There is no problem. But because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you that little choice to do and don't, making good or bad, that's why we corrupted everything. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even He gave you the choice, He did not just give it to you and do whatever you want, man. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He gave us the choice and He said, I will send you my rules through the Quran and the deen. You have to follow my rules. Otherwise, you're going to make corruption on earth. That's why He said, وَلَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Don't make mischief on earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. When you see people now, for example, I said that before, the one who make that DDT for the insects. They used to give it to the Middle East 1950s and 60s to kill certain insects. Same, they kill the human being. Actually, they kill the human being. And you know, all of these insects or whatever Allah created, they live in circles. And they cut this circle. They cut it. They make corruption. Khalas. It is not just for the insects. They're going to kill too many things around. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this to get benefit from that. Others are going to get benefit from this. And subhanallah. That's why we see, for example, the sun is coming. And you see vegetation is coming because of the sun. The animals, they are eating it. And they are growing. We are eating the meat of the animals and getting the milk. And subhanAllah, everybody's getting benefit from another one. It's your silsila, it's a chain. And when you put something in the middle, corruption. That whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to us. This is called mischief, corruption. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I give you some ikhtiyar, some choices, but with a limit. And with do and don't. افعل ولا تفعل. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you have to follow the manhaj of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His laws, otherwise you're gonna be in big corruption. He said, ولا تفسدوا في الأرض بعد إصلاحها. Do not make mischief on earth after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set everything on it in order. بعد إصلاحها. بعد إصلاحها. Why Allah said بعد إصلاحها? Because jinn, they corrupted. And then Allah fixed it. Right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He created in the beginning, it was Allah set it in order. That's why He said بعد إصلاحها. طيب, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make إصلاح for certain thing, means it's been corrupted before. Because if you say, for example, this cellular phone, mashallah, I bring it, it's working. But now it's not working. I have to give it to the man to fix it. That's why Allah said after being set in order, after Allah fixed it, means it was not in order before because jinn, they make a lot of mischief. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنِّي جَعْلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةِ, what the malaika said, أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفُكُ الدِّمَاءِ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ فِيهَا. قَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. اسكتوا. Yeah, I know but you don't know. فالله سبحانه وتعالى, He mean it in the Quran. بعد إصلاح. وَلَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بَعْدَ إِصْلَاحِهَا. Do not make mischief on earth after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set everything on order in it. بعد إصلاحها. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fixed. طيب, look what Allah said at the end of this ayah. He said, عز وجل is giving us a very good gift here. وادعوه خوفا وطمعا. The ayah before that ayah, I was explaining 40 days, he said, ادعوا ربكم تضرعا وخفيا. Invoke, supplicate your Lord تضرعا with humility and وخفيا in secret. Remember when I was explaining that before tonight? Huh? You have to humble yourself when you make dua. Don't tell Allah, yes, give me this and this. Allah is not working for you. It's not your... Even when you make dua, don't make dua because you need something. Make it as a ibadah. And Allah will take care of you. من شغله ذكري عن مسألتي أعطيته أفضل مما أعطي السائلين. Make it dua as a zikr. If you will be busy with the zikr of Allah, Allah will give you more than anybody is asking him. Because, don't ask Allah because I'm raising my hand to you, Rabb, because I put my conditions. You have to give it to me. Huh? Allah is not working for you. He's not your worker, huh? Your employee. Subhanallah. You have to humble yourself to Allah. He said, "Udu Rabbakum, supplicate your Lord, tadarru'an, humility, wa khufiya, in secret." In this ayah, he said, "Udu'uhu, wad'uhu, invoke Allah Azza wa Jal, khawfan, with fear, wa tama'a, and hope." Khawfan min sifatil jalal. What's sifatil jalal? Al-Qahar. المنتقم للصفات الجلال انتقام revenge because Allah can punish you وطمع that's why you have to have fear from صفات الجلال شيخ شعراوي said that وطمع من صفات الجمال والصفات الجمال الله رحيم كريم ودود huh? You have to have hope in his mercy see بقول لك انت that's why in our عباده we have to worship Allah with two wings this is exactly the right way to worship Allah. Some people, they worship Allah only because they fear Jahannam. This is not right. What is Allah Rahim, Kareem, Wadu? Somebody said, no, Allah is not Muntakham, Allah is not Jabbar, Allah is not, he will not punish me. Allah Rahim, Kareem, Wadu, I'm not praying. I'm not going to the masjid because he's going to forgive me anyway. It's not right too. You have to worship Allah with two wings like this. The wing of fear and the wing of hope in his mercy. Tayyib, how can you balance this? And these two wings will carry you to Allah, Nur Abad. خوفاً وطمعاً fear and hope. The scholars when I read about this they said خوف how? He said if you are مثلا young like Brother Muhammad or Brother Muhammad mashallah still young شباب mashallah they are very hyper they can do too many things shaitan can he said it's okay I'm still young I can do whatever I want okay what can you do? You have to put the fear 90% more than the hope and just 10% hope. What about if he became old guy like me? Kharban, khalas, his foot close to the grave. I cannot do anything anymore. Khalas, man, kharbana. Ele darab darab ul harab harab ya ussam, ya Mischief Samir. Say, ya Mischief Samir. It's over, ya Mischief Samir. Aywa. It's over. Khalas, I'm going to my grave. You have to put the hope 99%, 99.99% and fear 1%. يا رب خلاص I'm مسكين I'm weak I'm about to come to you what am I gonna do I'm your عبد I'm مسكين I'm poor yeah, you are the strong one I'm weak you are rich I am poor I have nothing in my hand forgive me please this is the way you know فدس والله how to balance this خوفا وطمعا ودعوه خوفا وطمعا this is how to invoke Allah to worship Allah. طيب I will end this ayah beautiful end of this ayah number 56 in the chapter of the height. إن رحمة الله قريب من المحسنين. Indeed, the mercy of Allah is very near to those who are good doers, the people of good. رحمة الله قريب من المحسنين. طيب, look at what it said. لا إله إلا الله. الرحمة, رحمة الله تعالى, يتحدث قربها منك أن تكون من المحسنين. The condition is you have to be one of the محسنين, then the رحمة الله will come close to you. طيب. You have to be one of the muhsineen or the rahmah. يعني you have to, you're going to get the rahmah, then make ihsan. Or you have to make ihsan, then you're going to get the rahmah. Which one? You have to make ihsan first. To be one of the muhsineen, the good doers, then the rahmah will come close to you. إن رحمة الله قريب من المحسنين. For example here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Hadith Qudsi, لا أمل حتى تملوا. Allah will never get tired and never get, Allah never going to get tired. Allah will never gonna stop sending His rahmah to you until you stop asking Him. See? Just if you keep asking Allah, Allah will shower you with His mercy. Number two. For example, He gave you salawat, five times salah. Okay? And He said, you come to me, make wudu, come to me, stand before me. I'm very near to you. And more you will be near to me when you make sujood. أقرب ما يكون العبد إلى ربه وهو ساجد. When you make sujood. Not just say that. He said, I will give you the door is still open. After the five times, door is still open. You can pray anytime. You can come to me anytime. Don't worry about it. I am very near to you. This is one thing. And they said also, وَمَنْ جَاءَنِي يَمْشِي أَتَيْتُهُ هَرْوَلَةً. If you are coming to me walking, I will run to you. Allahu Akbar. Means what? If you're tired, don't make yourself tired. I will run to you. I will never get tired, but you're going to get tired. If you come walking to me, I will run to you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more you make ihsan, you make good, His rahmah will be very close to you. That rahmah could be what? Health, happiness, iman, hidayah, good wife, good children, money, barakah, blessings. MashaAllah. Name it, name it. And it's countless. For rahmat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be or could be into many different ways. It is not just the money, or it is, do you know that wallahi al-azim time you're coming to the masjid and you sit here, you are on wallahi al-azim, you are into His rahmah. Wallahi, you are into His rahmah, His hidayah, His sakina. Allah said, Allahu nuru samawat wal ard. Allah is the extensive light of the heaven and the earth. Where is that light? He said, fi buyutin adhina Allahu an turfa'a wa yudhkara fi hasma. In His house. Rahmah, mercy, tranquility, hidayah, guidance, sakina, forgiveness. All we will hear when you come and you put yourself into His rahmah in His masjid. He said in Surah An-Nur, Subhanahu fi buyutin adhina Allahu wa yudhkara fi hasma. Yusabbihu lahu fiha bil ghuduwa wal asar rijal, like you, men, real men. لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار ليجزيهم الله أحسن ما عمل ويزيدهم من فضله لا إله إلا الله. فعايز أقول لك إن more you will come close to Allah, Allah will run to you. He said, ومن ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي. If you remember Allah inside in your نفس inside your heart, Allah will remember you there too. وَمَنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَئٍ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي مَلَئٍ خَيْرٌ مِنْهِ خَيْرٌ مِنْهِ. If you remember Allah in a mala' like where we are, this is mala' where we are now. Allah will take a copy of this above His arsh right now to His great angels. He's mentioning your name right now. This is according to the hadith. ف we can say like what Sheikh Sha'rawi said, إِنَّ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ فِي يَدِكَ. Where is the rahmat of Allah? It is in your hand. You got it? It is in your hand. Rahmah of Allah in your hand? Yes. What I'm talking about before 15 minutes. That's all you can, you are the one who can create the rahmah of Allah and you have it in your hand. More you come close to Him. Inna rahmatullahi qareebun min al-eh? Min al-muhsineen. And he said, rahmatullahi qareeb, rahmatullahi qareeb. Tab rahmah in Arabic language, rahmah female. That's it, right? Rahmah is female, it's not a male. Huh? It's a mu'annath, it's not mudhakkar. Right? You have to say إن رحمة الله قريبة, not قريب. Said والملائكة بعد ذلك, ملائكة females also, the angels, they are females. والملائكة بعد ذلك, you have to say ظهيرة. وإن رحمة الله رحمة مؤنث, تأنيسة تاء. You have to say قريبة. But this is Allah's language, the language of the Quran. And طبعا of course there are too many meanings in the grammar for that, but there is no time to explain. But anyway. We can understand it from, don't make mischief on earth. Keep it as is. Get the benefit. The earth, it is the makan, the place of the Khalifa of Allah Azza wa Jal for earth. Worship Allah with hope in His mercy and Jannah. And also fear from His punishment in the same time. And also more you worship Allah, more you make ibadat. You will be one of the good doers, al-muhsineen, al-ihsan, Islam, Iman, then ihsan. You cannot get the ihsan without the Iman. You cannot be a mu'min without the Islam. One after another, like that. Al-ihsan, taba'an, I can explain it, just a second, I will finish. Al-ihsan has two meanings. One meaning, anything extra of what you are doing, they call it ihsan. For example, you make zakat, you give zakat. When you give more voluntary sadaqah, this is ihsan from you are muhsin. You pray your five times salah, and you make tahajjud or nawafil or qiyam layl, they call it ihsan. You make hajj, and khalas hajj is enough. You make umrah, this is called ihsan. Anything extra from your ibadat, this is called ihsan. You make ihsan, mashallah, jazakallah khair. And he said another meaning of ihsan, hal an ta'bud Allah ka annaka tara, fa in lam takun tara fa innahu yara. To worship Allah as if you see Him. But if you cannot see Him, He sees you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is ihsan. Purity. For that's why I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Rabb, an yaj'alni wa iyyakum min al-muhsinin. I'm asking Allah to make us all amongst the muhsinin, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair.